Philippines wins a seat in the United Nations body that facilitates implementation of the UN Convention on the Law of the Sea, or UNCLOS. Manila competed with 8 other candidates for a seat in the Asia-Pacific group of the Commission on the Limits of the Continental Shelf. During Wednesday's elections in New York, the Philippines secured 113 votes from a total of 164 state parties. The country will be represented in the commission by ocean governance expert Efren Carandang from 2023 to 2028. This will be the first time that the Philippines will serve in that commission, which aims to set limits for national rights on the ocean floor. Earlier, Manila's top diplomat, Teodoro Loxin Jr., expressed disappointment over Australia's decision not to support the Philippines' candidacy. The Australian embassy said it does not disclose specific details on its voting intentions, but it highly values its maritime ties with the Philippines. These developments come as Manila and Beijing are still locked in a dispute over parts of the West Philippine Sea. Malacanang says it is unsure if bloggers would be allowed to cover the inauguration of President-elect Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Access to Malacanang coverage or palace events was traditionally limited to journalists from TV and radio networks, online news outfits, and newspapers. But Communication Secretary Martin Andanar allowed the accreditation of select social media users through a department order in 2017. Incoming Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles earlier said she would push for the accreditation of bloggers in Malacañang.
Meron po tayong existing social media blogger accreditation policy noong 2017 pa po yan. Noong kasama ko pa po si Assistant Secretary Mocha Uson. Meron na po kami niyan. Pero wala po kaming na-accredit na blogger kasi wala pong nag-apply. Pero hindi po natin alam this coming inauguration kung meron pong magko-cover ng inauguration po ng mga blogger po. Anything to do with the inauguration on whether or not bloggers will be allowed to the event is already po the jurisdiction ng incoming administration.
The Private Hospitals Association of the Philippines recommends Dr. Ted Erbosa as the next health secretary. Erbosa is an advisor of the National Task Force Against COVID-19. He was also Department of Health Undersecretary from 2010 until 2015 and Executive Vice President of the UP System from 2017 until 2021.
Well, sa amin pong hanay, alam po, meron po mga hospitals, mga different medical societies, even the PMA, meron po kaming nire-recommend na hopefully siya pong tanggapin ng ating President-elect Marcos na siya pong gawing Secretary of Health. But of course, the final decision ay sa kanila pa rin po. At yun po, ang amin pong nire-recommend ay si Dr. Ted Erbosa. Palagay ko, bago po dapat siguro mag-umpisa ang ating President-elect, dapat po may bigay po siyang pangalan na po. And then, ang inaasahan po namin, siyempre, kami sa hanay ng medical community, ay yung pong open at makakatulong po sa ating mga doctors, sa ating hospitals, at saka sa different healthcare facilities po.
Deputy House Speaker Conrado Estrella III says a lot of house cleaning is in order when he begins his stint as chief of the Agrarian Reform Department. Estrella says he wants to check if the agency's data on land ownership and its amortization table are still updated. He also plans to prioritize a land dispute involving the so-called Tinang 83. They're the farmers and land reform advocates in Tarlac Province who were arrested and charged for trying to claim the land, which they say was already given to them back in 1995.
That is one thing that I'd like to find out, get to the bottom of it. Why there are some beneficiaries whose names already are in the collective CLOA, but do you know that up to now they have not yet? They were not able to enter the stands assigned to them. In some places, I was told that some of the beneficiaries were not able to enter the lands assigned to them. No? Kasi may konting pressure from the original landowner. merong konting, you know, all those sorts of things, may harassment, ganun. And that is one thing that I'd like to look into also. And as much as possible, we could prevent incidents like Hacienda Tina.
Incoming DAR Chief Estrella also believes it's not possible to lower the price of rice to 20 pesos per kilo in the near future. This is contrary to an earlier statement of outgoing Agrarian Reform Chief Bernie Cruz, who said this could be done as early as the second quarter of 2023 through a mega farm or consolidated production.
I myself spend my days also in the field. I'm a farmer. And I had a dialogue with some farmers. Sabi ko sa kanila, halika kayo, posible ba ito na mapalabas natin ang farm gate price natin is at least 10 pesos? Kinompute namin yung cost sa tractor, sa ganito, sa ganyan, etc. Fertilizer, and all inputs. No? Hindi kaya. Hindi talaga kaya. Ang posible, 14. Which means kung farm gate price ay 14, no, pagdating dun sa miller,
28.
At pagkatapos dun sa retailers, pwede tayo sa 28.